In order to figure out the shear force and bending moment diagram, you first need to figure out the support reactions at point A and B. Since all the loads are acting vertically downwards, we are interested in the vertical support reactions. So writing our equilibrium equation of summation of forces acting along the y-axis equals to zero, we can simplify the expression as Ay plus By equals to 1200. Next, the second equilibrium equation can be written as summation of moment at point B equals to zero, taking counterclockwise as positive. Our resultant value of Ay is coming 450. Now plugging in the value of Ay into equation 1, we can get the By of 750 pounds. Now once we have the support reactions, we can now draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. So to draw the shear force diagram, we recall that point loads basically cause either jump up or jump down on the shear force diagram. So since at point A we have a load of 450 going upward, so our diagram will jump upward at 450 pounds. Next, the load is of 200 pounds that is acting in the downward direction. That will cause the jump down from 450 to 250. Similarly, there is a jump down of 400 at 12 feet from point A, and again a jump down of 400 pounds that is at 18 feet from point A. That will cause our shear force diagram to go to negative 550. Finally, at point B, there is a force of 750 going in the upward direction and 200 pounds going in the downward direction. The resultant force is 550 pounds going in the upward direction. Next, we can draw the bending moment diagram utilizing the area under the curves of shear force diagram. So starting at point A, since there is no area at point A, so we will start the bending moment diagram as 0 pound fit. Next, we have this rectangular area of 450 times 6. If we multiply them together, we get 2700. That will be the bending moment at the location where 200 pound load is being applied. Next, we have to figure out how this moment is changing from 0 to 2700, and we figure that thing out based on the slopes. So since the shear force diagram has a slope of 0 at this point, for the bending moment, the slope will be linear. Next, we have an area of 250 times 6. If we multiply them together and add up the 2700 in it, we get 4200. Similarly, we have now an area in the negative zone of 150 times 6. So we have to subtract from 4200 the 120 times 6, and it gives us 3300. Finally, in the last section, we have to subtract again 550 times 6 from 3300, and it gives us the value of 0.